Hey, get this. There are more than 100 billion microbes living in a single apple, and billions on an office keycard. But as for a toilet seat, well, there are much fewer bacteria on it than you think. Really, we've counted. Microbes are everywhere, but there's a lot more to it than that. You're in a hurry to get to work, but suddenly feel like using the bathroom. You're far from both home and the office, and you feel you don't have much time. You find some cafe, run to the bathroom, lower the toilet seat, and freeze. Who sat here before me? How many germs are on there, you think? Then you tear off a long stretch of toilet paper, divide it into sheets, and cover the seat. Or just put the whole stretch on it in a V shape. And only after that, you finally sit down. Sounds familiar? Well, I've got good news and bad news for you. The bad news is, the paper won't help save you from germs. Good news, you don't have to waste time covering the seat with it. The fact is that toilet paper isn't an obstacle for germs and bacteria. It absorbs moisture, which makes it an excellent place for microbes to reproduce. Your skin, on the other hand, is much more reliable than paper. Microscopic organisms can't pass through it. There is nothing to worry about as long as the toilet seat looks dry and there are no cuts on your behind and hips. But if you're still anxious, the best option would be to use sanitary tissues. Just wipe the seat with them before sitting down. Toilet seats are actually much cleaner than other places in the bathroom. A lot of bacteria live in places people touch with unwashed hands, that is, the sinks, doorknobs, or rolls of toilet paper. When you finish your business, lower the toilet lid before flushing. Clean water gets mixed with dirty, and splashes of it fly to the surface and contaminate everything around – walls, floor, and even toilet paper. In a way, you sit on even more bacteria when you cover the seat. Wash your hands for 20 to 30 seconds with warm water and soap. Don't close the tap with your hand. Use a tissue or paper towel for this. And try not to touch anything with your hands on the way out. Another important question, how to dry your hands? Using a paper towel or hand dryer? Lots of microbes live on both of them, but paper towels are safer. The hand dryer blows off germs both on your skin and across the bathroom. Or, you know, wipe your hands off on your pants. Oh, you do that too? Relieved, in more ways than one, you leave the bathroom and go to work. But when you arrive, you don't even realize that you've come to a much dirtier place – your office. According to many studies, office space houses several hundred times more microbes than a toilet lid. The number reaches billions. Many people eat at their workplace. Crumbs fall on the keyboard, and it's difficult to get them out of there. It becomes a perfect place for germs to spread. The people around make the situation even worse. Some don't see the need to wash their hands. Others are a little sick. If you could see how many germs there are with your own eyes, you'd never step into the office again. Also, a lot of bacteria dwell on the key card. According to scientists, the number of germs on it can be several hundred times higher than your pet's toy. But don't you worry about it too much. If your immune system is all right, these microbes won't hurt you. Of course, there are superbacteria and dangerous viruses that defeat the immune system and can resist many antibiotics. So it's always best to consult your doctor if you feel unwell. Basic hygiene should help you avoid getting sick, though. So try following these simple rules. Don't touch your face with your hands, especially the eyes and nose. Frequently wash hands in warm water with soap. By the way, antibacterial soap is not much better at eradicating bacteria than common one, but it dries the skin, so stick to the ordinary. Use sanitary tissues or antiseptic gel, especially before meals. If you're sick, always wear a face mask to stop bacteria from spreading around. Some foods help get rid of harmful intestinal germs. These include manuka honey, garlic, raspberries, blueberries, strawberries, green tea, and broccoli. Yep, your mom was right, it is good for you. Drink more clean water and take more vitamins. And remember, your best protector against germs is your own body. So, the working day is over. You're taking public transport to go home. The dirtiest place here is the handrails. Thousands of people hold onto them with their bare hands, so try not to touch them. Finally, you come home and open the door. Home, sweet home, I'll be safe here, you think. Well, don't want to upset you, but no, you won't. Your house is also full of germs. And the toilet is the cleanest area here. Here are some of the most microbe-infested places. Game pads. The more friends you invite home to play the console, the more bacteria end up on the game pads. But don't only blame the guests. You leave much more germs on them yourself. Remember how many times you took the game pad with greasy hands while eating? That food grease helps bacteria grow. And you're not likely to remember the game pads while cleaning the house either. Mobile phone. This one is pretty clear. You rarely let it out of your hands. There just might be more bacteria on your phone than on the soles of your shoes. Kitchen board. Oh, the things you cut on it. Say you cut some zucchini on your board and forgot to wash it. Bacteria would stay and cling to anything you put there next. Wooden boards pose a higher risk, since bacteria can penetrate their fibers and remain there even through thorough washing. Don't just rinse it with water, but wash it with dishwashing liquid very carefully. Blender. The irony here is that a healthy protein shake or smoothie may become the source of harmful bacteria. They accumulate in hard-to-reach places where food gets stuck, between the blades. Don't be lazy and clean the blender at least once a week. Showerhead. Microbes accumulate inside it, and you risk breathing or swallowing bacteria when you turn on the water. This is especially dangerous for people with weak immunity. Turn on the water about a minute before you start to wash, and regularly clean the nozzle to reduce the number of germs. Sponge for dishes. A week is enough to accumulate a critical level of bacteria there. Just think about it. A wet, soft, warm place with microscopic pieces of food. Isn't that a paradise for bacteria? Uh-huh. Use antibacterial detergents to spoil germs' vacation. Squeeze and dry the sponge as best as possible. Change it once a week. Your favorite place in the house is also the dirtiest. It's the fridge. One of the main sources of bacteria is food packaging. Thousands of people walk past your products in supermarkets. Some pick them up and put them back. Meat is of a particular danger if it lives in your fridge for a long time. Try to put it away from other products so that the microbes don't spread to them. Regularly wash the shelves and the door. Among the trillions upon trillions of bacteria, there are a lot of safe ones, though. Many of them work for the good of your body and help our immunity. Microbes are responsible for almost every biological process on Earth. So they're not exclusively bad, you know. So if you think something's been bugging you, now you know. Hey, if you learned something new today, then give the video a like and share it with a friend. And here are some other cool videos I think you'll enjoy. Just click to the left or right, and remember, stay on the bright side of life.